Well, I proudly stand in front of what once was my great-grandfather's house and then my grandfather's house. But most of my memories growing up was when it was my Uncle Jack and Aunt Jean's house. And out here in the backyard, I guess my greatest memory is so many years of Easter egg hunts, Easter eggs being hidden in so many bushes here, a bar set up against the white barn over here, food, drinks, and refreshments, and Easter eggs strewn throughout all these different bushes and even across the street next to the library. My sister and I and my cousins and many family members would spend so many holidays here, but Easter was the big one. The spring was in front of us. Finding Easter eggs and having fun with the family here was probably one of my greatest memories.
Well, when I was at Villanova, it was right after they bought the place. It was about 1951. I had a Halloween party in here. All the guys from Villanova came. And there was no water in the place, so but there was a bathroom upstairs. So we got buckets of water and carried buckets of water from the garage over for the girls to go to the bathroom, and the guys all came out. And the story for years was that that tree would grow to be the biggest tree ever because everybody was outside peeing on the tree.
See, I never heard these stories. This is all new.
That's true.
My biggest memory here was a continuous red sitting area around a table here, and had so many dinners here and breakfasts here with my aunt and my uncle. And it was always fun to be here because my uncle was my godfather, and he was a great man, and just so many great memories here in this small little kitchen. And at one time, this was a very beautiful dining room, nice large wooden table, wooden chairs, many meals here with the family. And even after my aunt Jean passed away, my uncle had remarried to Ann Friel, and we also had many great dinners here. She would have a five-course meal, bring out the linen, bring out the silverware, and all the fine china. Great times, great memories, and great family people.
That's a weight to hold the window in place. As you...
The counters?
And each window had two of those. They're 5 pounds a piece.
Oh my.
So that's how heavy the window sash was. The window sash was like 10 pounds.
That is amazing.
Needed two of those. It's got the 5 pounds right written on it.
That is heavy.
So many gatherings here at Christmas time, Easter time, Thanksgiving, and still as I stand here today, I can remember so many family portraits. We had all lined up against this back wall here with my grandparents, aunts, uncles, mom, dad, sisters, cousins. It was just a great, great time. 452 was a little bit less crowded, but back in those days, being a small little boy, any cars or trucks coming down, it seemed like a lot of noise, it was a lot of activity, and you always felt like you're in the middle of the city. But I can still remember sitting out there as a little boy, probably 5 years old, sitting next to my grandfather and my Uncle Jack taking some pictures.
See this wide, that's the original floor. In those other rooms, that the hardwood floor has been installed, but this is the original floor.
I mean, this is where my Uncle Jack had his complete collection of rifles from World War I, World War II. They were all up, lined up and down on these walls. He was a collector of so many things, so many different wars. And this was like the staging area and a museum for all his collectibles. Heading upstairs was, as I look up the steps here, I can remember walking up here when I was young, once again, probably 4, 5, 6, 7 years old with my sister. Often we would stay overnight here on weekends with my aunt and uncle. And right here to the left was the bedroom that we used to sleep in. You know, everything just seemed so old, even though the house was updated with nice wallpaper, nice painting. Everything was all fixed up with great furniture in it, but it still had that old touch to it. And even being a little boy, you know, compared to the house that we grew up in, it was like you were going back in time.
When was the last time you've been in the attic?
The last time I was in this attic, it had to have been 25 years ago. So you want to take a walk upstairs in the attic? Wow. Yeah, this has been renovated from the times I can recall being up here. To think that we're going to be, the house is going to be knocked down tomorrow, and this is the first time I've seen the attic renovated to this condition, because my last memory is all the bats flying around up here. It got to the point where the renovation costs were just going to be so high that my dad decided that it was time to take it down.
I decided to tear it down because I couldn't get insurance on it. Because the roof is bad, so I got a price to repair the roof. And they said that the structure of the house was so bad, it was just to put a roof on it, put a roof over the whole thing was going to cost $26,000, and it's not worth it.
What will be put in its place? Just use it as a car lot?
Temporarily, it'll just be a flat lot here. Let the grass grow back, bring it back to the natural state, and let time see where it's going to be. Great memories, great house, a lot of great family history.